Good morning, students. I hope that you all are good and safe. Today, we are going to see an interesting topic, Pinocchio. Pronounce it, Pinocchio. Before going into the topic, I will ask you certain questions. First, what do you like to do? Yeah, I like to play. I like to dance. I like to sing a song. I like to read. I like to take care of plants, so on. Next, how do you play? Some of us would like to play with toys. Yes, imagine if your favorite toy becomes real, how do you feel? I feel excited, surprised, astonished. Yes, now tell me, what kind of pictures these are? Yes, these we call it as puppet. Puppet, it is a type of toy which looks like a person or animal whose actions are controlled by someone else. You can see even that rope in these pictures. Now, before going into the lesson, let me know about the author Carlo Collodi. His pen name Carlo Lorenzi. He was born on 24 November 1826. He was an Italian author and journalist who wrote for children. All of Collodi's works present children in a realistic light, infusing them with a mischievous nature with which youngsters easily identify. He is best known for his creation, Pinocchio the Puppet, whose adventures delight children around the world. Now come to this lesson. In the story, Geppetto, who was a carpenter and made many wooden puppets, but one of the puppets became real in his life. See, it began to dance and sing like the normal people. That is an ordinary people. So Geppetto called him Pinocchio as his son. Here, next day, Geppetto asked Pinocchio to go to school. Would you all like to go to school? Tell me truth. Most of us do not like to go to school. Similarly, Pinocchio refused to go to school. But Geppetto sent him to school. On the way to school, he saw a puppet show and Pinocchio danced with them happily. Next day, Geppetto gave him gold coins to buy a book. But he planted those gold coins under a tree in the orchard, which was told by a cunning cat and a sly fox. Cunning refers dishonest and a sly refers tactics. Now he thought he will get 100 gold coins. At last, nothing was there under the tree. He started to weep like that. Weep means cry. But those coins were taken by cunning cat and a sly fox. Meanwhile, a kind cat fairy, that is a small imaginary human form that has magical powers, especially a female one. You can see in this picture. Yes, that kind fairy came and asked Pinocchio, "What happened?" The naughty Pinocchio started telling lies. As he kept talking, his nose kept longer and longer. Pinocchio was shocked. "Why is this happening?" The blue fairy replies, "When you tell a lie, your nose grows longer and longer. There is no other way." So Pinocchio, "Please make it stop. I promise to be good always." The next day, Pinocchio met a boy who asked him to come to island. There you can see many toys, games and sweets and all. You can enjoy there. You no need to take books. You no need to learn anything in the school. Let you come and join with me. So Pinocchio went with the boy to Fun Island. There Pinocchio enjoyed a lot for 2 days. Enjoyed here by tossing balls. Tossing means throwing balls, riding a bicycle and swimming, so on. Similarly, their ears growing longer and they were growing a tail. Now they were turning into a donkeys. They were wandering hither and thither, that is here and there. The circus master, that is ring master, made Pinocchio work for the circus. While doing tricks, he got hurt and cried. Meanwhile, the blue fairy appeared. "Oh dear fairy," cried Pinocchio. "I didn't listen to my father. I didn't go to school. Now I turned into a donkey. Please help me to reach my father." The fairy said, "You were asking sorry, so I will take you to your father. See, your father, he was sailing far away. Now, Pinocchio, clap. That's my father on the ship." Both hugged each other in joy and reached home safely. Pinocchio said his father, "Hereafter, I will go to school and work hard to get a good job. That's why you will be free in your future. So, no need to go work again." Then Pinocchio became a brave and a kind-hearted boy. After seeing this, the blue fairy made Pinocchio a real boy. Geppetto and Pinocchio lived together happily. Can you tell me what is the moral of the story? Yes, be truthful always, avoid telling lies. Pinocchio fulfills fairy's requirements, that is being brave, truthful and selfish. Similarly, we have to fulfill our parents' requirements. Yes. I hope that you all enjoyed this story. Now, I will be asking you few questions. Let you answer for them. First question, how was Pinocchio made? Refer page number 1. Second, how did Pinocchio enjoy himself on Fun Island? Refer page number 3. Third question, what happened at the end of the story? Refer page number 4. Fourth question, your interesting question. Draw the fairy. Yes, I hope that you all understood this story. Thank you.